Hi, welcome back to Who May Be a Leader. And as we continue our walk through Douglas Wilson's book, Father Hunger, because we got a lot of children out there hungering for their fathers. We're coming to you from Progressive, Mexico, where I'm on taking a trip with my family. We're on a cruise, the Carnival, the Triumph. And so the thing about it today is we want to finish our walk through his book, because it's very exciting what some of the things that, and I don't know about for you, but it's a lot of different information, and sometimes different is good, sometimes fresh is good. And so we want to continue our walk. Last time we was with you, we was talking about putting on the full armor. Matter of fact, I broke down to you what that really means when we talk about it. Because the first thing that he talked about is talked about truth, that we should put on truth, because without truth, you really don't have any freedom to do anything else without truth. And I think that's the driving force to what we can get done for God, is that we would accept the truth and let it allow it to set us free, because God has called us to that. And then we talk about faith, because Satan has the ability to cause us to doubt God. Hebrews say, he who come to me got to believe that I am who I say I am, and that I'm a rewarder of those who seek me diligently. Not only that, he talks about shunning your feet, because a lot of times we get set up, we get caught in booby traps and stuff like that, and God is calling us to walk in a way that's worthy of the call, make the most of your time. I think what's going on today is that we have too much time that's unaccounted for. And what do I mean by that? It's too much time to where we ain't doing things for God, we're doing it for ourselves. It's two things that you're going to be faced with when you get up in the morning, either to please yourself or to please God. So we want to continue our walk and what God is really calling us to do through this book. Today we want to come from the educational perspective, because Douglas say that no institution can compensate for what a father can do, and I believe that. Paul told Timothy to follow me as I follow Christ, and men, we ought to want to be the one instilling in our kids what really needs to be done to get them to seek the kingdom first. That's the thing that we need to do. And the scriptures say everything else will be added unto them. And so listen to what Douglas say. Education is not simply a means of data transferring. A lot of times we seeking education because we want to appear to be smart. A lot of times we got a lot of smart people, but with no practical sense. Because we've learned the data, but we haven't learned how to work the data. And that's the thing that we want to talk about. And then he go on to say, he said it is not reduced to a state certified technical. We need to understand that it's just not that you get a degree, it's what you do with that degree. And a lot of times, I remember one of my professor saying, when I was over at College of Biblical Study, he said, I'm not concerned about the grade. He said, I'm concerned about that you understand what you have read and what you have received when it comes down to this class. He said, because if you do that, then you've been successful. Because the thing about it is, when you go into college, talking about biblical study, it's more of what you get in you that you're going to apply than anything else, because all college really simply does is show you that you went somewhere to get some organized teaching. But God has a way of organizing his teaching through fathers handing back down to their kids. And then he goes on to say that if you take a drivetrain out of a car, how can we be surprised when it don't run? It's the same thing when we're surprised as fathers when our kids act up and we haven't instilled anything in it. It's an investment. Just like God invests in us, he expects us to invest in our kids. And so remember, we talked about earlier up in this book that even when a father is not speaking, he's speaking. He talked about how God made himself known at Jesus' baptism. And that's the thing that we have to understand, is that we have to make ourselves known in our home. One of the things that my favorite pastime is just watching people. I love sitting and watching people, because I watch them trying their best to be somebody that they really not. and they straining to do it, they stressing to do it. And God is calling, he say we uniquely made, and so we can do what he say we can do because we have everything we need based on 2 Peter. But I'm gonna say it's a joy to me, but it's just fascinating to me as I watch people and how they move around and how they deal with one another in a way to where it don't really show the love of Christ. So we have to be careful. And then he talks about no system can successfully compensate for the replacement of what a father has been appointed to do. Ephesians 6 and 4 say, Father, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instructions of the Lord. Discipline and instruction. Now, a lot of people don't even believe in discipline these days. A lot of people believe in timeouts and stuff like that. But God say, if you spare the rod, you spoil the child. Matter of fact, we know that children, once they get spoiled, one of the things that I used to tell my children all the time, even if I could give you everything, I won't give you everything. For the simple reason, because you would know what to expect once you got in the world. Remember, the home is the simulation period. That's what we teach our kids, what to expect when they go out there. So if I spoil my kid in my home, if I spoil them, then when they go out into the world, they expect to be spoiled out there. And I promise you that the world is not going to spoil them. They're going to do some bad things to them. So we need to not set our kids up for failure. And we do that when we give them everything and don't allow them to work for things. And that not necessarily mean get a job work, but to figure thing out reasons for themselves and things like that. And so they have to understand. And then Doug is talking about his two critical things to notice about this requirement when he's talking about not provoking your children, but bringing them up. He said, first is the requirement of a Christian education for a Christian child. A Christian education for a Christian child. Now, that's not necessarily meaning that every child got to go to a Christian school, because a lot of people can't afford to send their children to Christian school. But what he's saying to you fathers and mothers, because I think it's the job of both, but mainly the father, because God has called you the headship, is that you teach your kids what it's all about, what it is to serve Christ, what it is to be a Christian, what God has truly called them to do, the purpose in which they should represent God. Because he said, walk worthy of the call that's been called on your life. So what he's saying is that each person is required to teach their children about Christianity and what their purpose is for it. He say, second is the commandment is laid at the feet of father. He say, it's the responsibility of a father. And remember, I said on my blog that if a man is not leading himself first, then the possibility of him doing it for a family is just not there. And I'm not saying it can't be there, but I'm saying if he's not doing it for himself, because the scriptures say love your wife as yourself, and meaning your whole family as yourself. And if you don't love yourself enough to get up, pray, read the scripture, and seek God on behalf of yourself, then the fact is that you're going to do that for a family. And so I want to challenge you men to this. I want to challenge you to get back to basics. I want to challenge you to get back to basics. I want to challenge you to start seeking God for yourself, to start praying for yourself. And then I want you to broaden it out. I want you to start praying with your wife and then seeking God on her behalf. And then I want y'all to start sitting down and reading scriptures together, because the scriptures say that we ought to learn how to stimulate one another through words before deeds. One of the reasons why when sex go bad, the relationship go bad, because guess what? We never learn how to stimulate one another through words. And God is calling us to learn how to stimulate. And I'm speaking from a Christian perspective. Those of you who are professing Christian, learn how to stimulate one another through words, because the physical is not all it is to it. And we want to know how to have a good conversation based on the word of God. So hey, there you have it. We need to be teaching our children, and we need to be sharpening one another. Hey, until I see you next time, I'm enjoying myself here on the cruise. Until I see you next time, may God bless you and keep you, as I pray. And remember, examine your life so you can balance your life. God bless you.